Hello everyone, I am Pana Shai. Welcome back. This is our third lecture in the lecture series of power measurement, and today we are going to discuss about calorimeter method. We have already discussed rheometer method and bolometer method. Today is calorimeter method, which has a different principle of measuring power at higher frequency, or you can say radio frequency. So first, we will understand what calorimeter method is about. It actually a radio frequency power, where a measurement technique where the radio frequency power can be observed directly into calorimeter fluid. This fluid can be water or salty water or any kind of fluid, and fluid may be used as a coolant for a resistive load or solid material. Actually, we know that you can also measure the power at higher frequency using the bolometer method, and by bolometer method using directional coupler can be used for high power measurement, high frequency power measurement. But calorimeter method is a principle that uses the conversion of radio frequency power into heat. So if you can measure the rise of temperature due to that heat, then we can measure the power accordingly. So calorimeter method is especially suited for the measurement of large power levels, that is 5 to 500 watts, and the relative performance, it is as you can see that normally we can use some fluid which can observe the heat of the RF power, and then we can measure the temperature rise of that fluid. Or another way is we can use a load that will observe the power, and then the load can be cooled using that fluid. So these are two methods which can be used. So the basic principle is that we are going to measure the temperature change due to the RF power absorption. So it is a very important that radio frequency power that is being transferred to the fluid should be transferred properly, and it should not generate any hot spots, because if at a particular point of the fluid flow, if the temperature rises than certain range, then obviously the fluid will change to boil. So it is important that there should not be any hot spots generated due to the absorption of power in the fluid. So the rate of fluid flow, the mass of fluid exposed to the heating, should be in such a proportion that a measurable temperature rise is obtained with every small amount of fluid absorbing the RF power. So you will get to understand the principle more by seeing this diagram. So this is the typical arrangement where we are trying to use a fluid which can absorb the power, RF power, and we want to measure the temperature difference of that fluid. So basically there can be many different arrangement of calorimeter method where different kind of fluid can be used, or we can use different type of arrangement we can make. But the basic principle is the power dissipated in any calorimeter can be calculated by using this equation. So if you know the specific heat of the fluid, you know the rate of flow of the fluid, and accordingly the relationship can be drawn like this. The power invert can be measured with this equation, where m is mass flow rate, the specific heat, and the temperature difference. So this formula can be used for any calorimeter arrangement where you want to measure the radio frequency power. So this is one arrangement, one of the many kind of arrangement of calorimeter method. Here you can see that all the things has been labeled here. So it utilizes a lossy cable which has been chosen, which utilizes a length of, which actually utilizes a length that can give you 10 dB of attenuation, which is somehow important for a particular operating frequency. It will ensure that at least 20 dB of attenuation for the reflective power, for the reflected power, and thus the load absorbs whatever load is will be used here, that will absorb virtually all of the incident radio frequency power delivered from the source. So it is important in what kind of cable you are choosing. Another point is that this cable that is available in, is this kind of cable is available in the standard impedance of 50 ohm. Hence, there is no problem of impedance matching. As the radio frequency system, we know that line impedance is of 50 ohm. So the impedance matching is the problem of impedance matching is solved here, because the cable that we have used here and the cable that is that has been chosen here is of 50 ohms only. So this arrangement, you can see that the cable has been chosen for maximum impedance matching. That means it will transfer the maximum power, and the fluid that we are using is water. So this will make sure this fluid will make sure that it absorbs the it absorbs no radio frequency power itself. The water won't be absorbing the power itself, but it will serve as a coolant only. So the RF input power that is falling through the lossy cable, the water will enter through this, and there is a water jacket you can see, and there is a thermal insulation has been done in this arrangement. So this water that is entering here is a normal water, normal temperature, has a normal temperature range, and then there is a temperature, so it will measure the temperature of the incoming water, and here in the, this some point the flow of water and the power of the inside the lossy cable, it will observe the power, it will try to cool the RF cable, and then the temperature that has an the temperature rise of that incoming water will be can be read from this thermometer. Here you can see it is donating as water out. So this typical arrangement is just measuring the, you can see the, it is just measuring the temperature difference of the incoming water and the outgoing water of in the from the cable arrangement that has been made. So this is one type of arrangement, and this equation can be used for this arrangement. Here we can see this is for, it can be used for any measurement where we know the temperature difference of temperature rise of any fluid that we are using. So another arrangement is this, a typical arrangement that is also a calorimeter meter. So here it is using a titanium dioxide tapping. So tapping is, we have studied earlier that tapping is done to for the impedance matching. So in this arrangement, because we have the 50 ohm cable line, that's why we don't need any tapping or we don't need impedance matching. But in this arrangement, you can see this is a coaxial cable that is coming. And here this arrangement has been done in such a way, there is two different dielectrics available. One is where the dielectric is air, you can see here the air is present in this part of the cable, and there is another arrangement where the water is coming in this arrangement. So the dielectric of water and the dielectric of air. Okay, so these two different arrangement matching section has been done here in this part. So here you can see that the matching of these two portions where the dielectric element has been changed is done by this titanium dioxide tapering. So you can see this portion has been tapered so that the impedance matching can be done. The maximum power transfer can be done from this portion to this portion where the RF input is for cloning. So these are you can see there has been this So by using titanium dioxide, because the this metal titanium dioxide has a very dielectric constant which is very equal to the dielectric constant of water, that is approximately 80. So this is used for impedance matching of these two sections where we have two different dielectric, and here the air is available, there is a water available. Okay, and the next thing is that we can see there is a this hot and cold junction thermocouple junction that you can see has been labeled. Yes, this is actually called thermopile. So thermopile is a you can say it's a thermocouple junction connected in succession. So every junction is one junction is connected in alternating manner. So you can see that one junction is in water out and water in. That means one junction is in cold water, another one is in hot water. So alternatively, it will measure the temperature difference in this circuit, which is actually more accurate compared to the if we use one junction of thermocouple, it is more accurate to use a succession of thermocouple junction, that is thermopile. So here you can see the water is coming in and it is flowing in this path, and it is going through this path after observing the RF power, after being used as a coolant for the RF input power. And again there is two path where the water is flowing, and the difference of water, the temperature of temperature difference of incoming water and the outgoing water is being measured in this part of the circuitry. So here again we are measuring the temperature difference only of this from the syringe. So this measurement calibration can also be done by using a defined we can say by observing the thermocouple thermopile response, by observing the thermopile response for a known power measurement. For the non power, let's assume we use this arrangement earlier for 60 hertz power, and we see how the thermopile temperature difference shows for the particular temperature measurement if you know that power. And again we measure for unknown power, that is your RF input power. So calibration can be done in this way. The fluid has been normally is used as a tap water, or it can be used for salty water can also be used in this section. So this is another arrangement for impedance matching, and there is so you can go through these lines. Yeah, so the only difference is that for temperature difference we are measuring thermocouple and thermopile instead of thermometers, and here the tapping has been done by using titanium dioxide, and dielectric elements is same. So radiofilm is also in water section of the line. Yeah, so another arrangement of a calorimeter method is in wave flight, water load using tap of wave. So this is another measurement. You can see one tube has been used where the fluid will be flowing, and the metal gauge and the RF input power, the same principle will be used here also, that the fluid in the tube will observe the power, RF input power, and we can measure the temperature difference of the water in and the water out in this section also. So this this arrangement can also be used for, in the is actually this arrangement is for waveguide, for waveguide, not for coil cell cable. And you can go through the details and refer to this book for further details. Thank you for now. We will meet for another lecture. soon.